Okay, thank you for introduction. The subject of my talk is the Ronald Baum effect with fractionally charged quasi particles in quantum Hall systems. Naively, the interference of fractionally charged quasi particles should lead to Ronald Baum oscillations with periods larger than Lux quantum. Experimentally, this effect have been recently observed, but theoretically it is still a subject of a debate because the arguments leads to controversy. In this work, in collaboration with Eugene Sukhrukov and Jurg Frölich, we make an attempt to resolve this controversy. Actually, for rational charge of quasi particles has been observed in experiments based on measurement of noise power of backscattering current. But the direct measurement of quasi-particles charge should be the measurement of a Ronald Baum phase. To detect this phase, one can use the electronic analog of an optical Mach-Zehnder interferometer, as we have already seen. In this electronic interferometer, edge channels play a role of beams in usual interferometer. Quantum point contacts are used as beam splitters. And here, and ohmic contacts as source and rain. At Fillinger factor 1 over m, the charge of quasi particles is E over m. Thus, naively, the value of Ronald Baum phase, which is picked up by the quasi particles in this loop, is m times smaller than for electrons, and the period of quasi particles current should be m times larger. But from the other point of view, the Byers-Young theorem states that for arbitrary electronic system, if we insert the Lux quantum, this system relaxes to the same state as before the insertion. Thus, All the observables in electronic systems and our interferometer is made of electrons should have the periodicity with flux as a flux quantum, such as flux quantum, which looks as a contradiction with the naive argument. Okay, to resolve this paradox, we follow several steps. First of all, we microscopically derive the effective theory of quantum Hall liquid in presence of changing magnetic flux. For the filling factor 1 over m, state of the electrons is described by the wave function shown here, where the part of the, of the wave function shown here in red describes the shape of the region where the electrons are present. Such states form a subset of the incompressible gapless deformations of quantum Hall liquid, and after the projection on such subspace, all the observables can be expressed via the set of parameters AK, which describe deformations. On this subspace, this parameters AK became a bosonic annihilation operator and can be grouped into fields, into chiral boson fields, which describe the low energy physics of our quantum Hall liquid. Importantly, we implement the projection for two different cases. In first case, we change the flux with help of a singular flux tube in the center of the interferometer. And in the second case, the flux is varied by the application of modulation gate voltage. Okay. As a result of this projection, we obtain the edge Hamiltonian and the amplitudes of tunneling of quasi particles at quantum point contacts. In both situations, edge Hamiltonian depends on the magnetic flux only via the induced charge densities, as we can see here, and this is just contribution from the homogeneous charge density. Surprisingly, in case of a singular flux, the tunneling, the amplitude of tunneling does not depend on the singular flux. Thus, there should not be a Aronov-Bohm effect associated with this flux. In contrast, in case of a modulation gate, tunneling amplitudes do depend on the flux via this multiplier. We can give the physical interpretation to this result if we take into account that there are two contributions to Aronoff Bohm phase in case of quantum Hall effect. First contribution is just to external magnetic flux, while the second contribution is due to the physical deformation of the quantum Hall droplet. Locally, these two effects can be different, but globally they exactly cancel each other in case of singular flux. So we can interpret this as a topological screening of the singular flux by the bulk of quantum Hall liquid. Okay, after we have described the effective theory of the isolated quantum Hall liquid, we have to include the processes at the ohmic contacts. To do so, we recall that besides the deformations, the wave function has quantum numbers such as a number of electrons on inner and the outer edge of the interferometer and the number of quasi-particle L in the interferometer. Number of electrons is changed due to tunneling from and to the ohmic contacts, while the number of quasi-particles changes due to tunneling in the quantum point contacts from inner edge to the outer and back. Okay, due to the wrong tunneling at ohmic contacts, density matrix in electronic sector is just a product of two equilibrium distributions, which depends on the number of quasi-particles and singular flux as a parameter. And after the application of magnetic flux, edge states changed similarly to the effect of change of N or L. And it can be relaxed further with the electron tunneling. After the summation of the electronic number, we come to the master equation in the quasi-particle sector with the following tunneling rates. Okay, to solve the master equation and to find the quasi-particles current, one needs first to find this tunneling rates. For weak tunneling, this can be done in leading order with help of our effective theory. In case of singular flux, this tunneling rates are functions only of the linear combination of the quantum numbers NL and phi, which is natural, as we see on the previous slide. While in case of modulation gate, tunneling rates contain also additional phase factor which comes from the tunneling amplitudes. The sum over n is calculated in thermodynamic limit, and the leading order is just given by the integral over n. Thus, for the case of singular flux, we have a constant result, while for the case of the modulation gate, we have the function which is periodic in flux with larger quasi-particle period. In the next order, in case of singular flux, tunneling rates contain phase factor which depends on the number of quasi-particles. And after summation over this number, the electronic periodicity is restored. We conclude that the oscillations in case of singular flux are suppressed in thermodynamic limit and thus could be interpreted as a Coulomb blockade effect. While in case of modulation gate, they survive in thermodynamic limit and present a quasi-particle Aronoff-Bohm effect. One important aspect of our work as compared to other works is the effect of screening of the magnetic flux through the hole in the interferometer. This effect is as well present in our theory at Fehling factor nu equal 1, and thus could be easily tested in the experiment in which the size of the hole inside the interferometer is significantly changed with the additional gate, while the area of the quantum hole liquid inside the interferometer remains unchanged. From our theory, we predict that the periodicity in homogeneous magnetic field should not change after the application of the gate. Nevertheless, the area of the interferometer naively is changed. So here is my conclusions, and thank you for your attention. Here we have different results for the singular flux and modulation gate, because this effect about what you just said is due to this factor. You see that this factor is exactly the effect of the increase of the number of quasi-particles of inside the interferometer, but it is suppressed in thermodynamic limit and seen only in singular flux.
One very short question.
Well, just a historical perspective. This question about the risk thing was first raised by Phil Anderson. Then in the early 90s, Thomas and I wrote a paper explaining this lack of paradox and showing how one can reconcile the fractional charge. Okay. And also implicitly master equation.
Okay, but I would like just to comment on this question. Yes, because in all before works, all papers present the mechanisms of suppression of quasi-particle periodicity, which do not distinguish the situations with modulation gate and singular flux. Here we show that these two situations indeed completely different. Namely, in one case, we did have the restoration of electronic periodicity, while in case of the modulation gate, we still have large quasi-particle periods, which is direct signature of the fractional charge.
Thank you.